Now in the chapter moving charges and magnetism, electromagnetics, magnetic field induction, magnetic field induction, right, due to current carrying solenoid. Current carrying solenoid. Magnetic field induction due to current carrying solenoid. An insulated conducting wire is wound on a cylinder is said to be solenoid. Current carrying straight conductor. This is the current carrying straight conductor. Now this is what to say, current carrying circular coil. Now let us consider current carrying solenoid. What do you mean by the solenoid? There is a cylinder. Now this is the cylinder. This is the cylinder. This is the cylinder. Cylinder. Now, what is the cylinder of radius? Capital R is the cylinder of the radius. Now, what is the length of the cylinder? L is the length of the cylinder. Now, here on this cylinder, an insulated copper wire is wound. An insulated copper wire is wound. Now copper wire is like this. This is the copper wire. Insulated copper wire is wound. Now this is the wire, right, like this. Right, this is the insulated copper wire. Now, this is the incoming current. This is the incoming current. This is outgoing current. Now, the current is, this is the copper cylinder. This is the cylinder. Right? The wire is wound. The wire is wound like this. The wire is wound like this. How the current is passing? Let us consider the current is passing like this. Right? As the current is passing like this, with respect to this one, this is the clockwise current. Now, with respect to opposite side, that is anti-clockwise current. Through the clockwise current, as the current is traveling through the clockwise, this surface will behave as a south pole. Now from this surface the current is in anti-clockwise direction. This surface behaves as a north pole. Now here this is called, what to say, axial line of the current carrying solenoid. Now what is the amount of current? I is the amount of the current. Now, what are the parameters of the, right? We can write. Now, radius of the solenoid. Radius of solenoid is equals to capital R. Now, length of the solenoid. Length of solenoid is equals to capital L. right? Now, number of turns, right, per unit length, number of turns per unit length is equals to n, right? For a unit thickness, for a unit length, how many number of turns? N is the number of turns. This is very important property. Number of turns per unit length is small n. Now, next one. Right. Current passing through solenoid
is I.
Now, for understanding purpose, right, the solenoid is represented by like this. This is the solenoid. For the sake of convenience, I am showing without any wires. Right? Now this is called, what to say, axial line of the solenoid. Now this is the radius of the solenoid. Right? Let us consider. At any particular point, P, I want to calculate the magnetic field induction. At any point P, I want to calculate the magnetic field induction. What is the magnetic field induction? B is the magnetic field induction. Right? Now, in order to calculate the magnetic field induction inside a point on the axial line, now the total solenoid is divided into number of infinitesimal thicknesses. Now there is a current carrying solenoid, right? Inside the coil there is a magnetic field. At a particular point in the solenoid, we want to calculate the magnetic field induction, right? What formula we are using? By using Biot-Savart law, B is equals to, right, closed integral, sorry, mu naught, right, by 4 pi into I dl sin theta by r square. This is the Biot-Savart law. Now, by using the Biot-Savart's law, right, for current carrying circular coil, right, magnetic field induction B is equals to mu naught I n r square by 2 into r square plus x square whole to the power of 3 by 2. Now, this is the Biot-Savart's law formula. By using the Biot-Savart's law formula, now I am considering current carrying circular coil. On the axis of the current carrying circular coil, right, what is the magnetic field induction? B is equals to mu naught I n r square by 2 into r square plus x square whole to the power of 3 by 2. Now here in this case. But what is my aim? Magnetic field induction due to the current carrying solenoid. Now, therefore, here this is called solenoid. This solenoid is divided into number of infinitesimal points. Circular coils. Now this is called solenoid. It is divided into number of infinitesimal points. Right? Therefore, it is divided into number of infinitesimal circular coils. Now this is the solenoid. Right? It is divided into number of portions. Right? Each portion behaves as a circular coil. Right, let us consider this is the one portion. This is the one portion. What is the thickness? What is the thickness of the portion? Dx. Right? Now this is called solenoid. Right? To calculate the magnetic field induction inside the coil, for that purpose, I am dividing this solenoid is number of infinitesimal small portions. But if you divide into number of small portions, each portion behaves as a circular coil. Now this is called, this is the circular coil. Right, this portion. What is the thickness of the circular coil? Dx. Now this circular coil, this is a circular coil, which is at a distance of x from the point P. Now this is the circular coil, this is the circular coil, right, of thickness x, of thickness x. From the circular coil, now our required point P is at a distance of x. Therefore, this is, as a whole, it is a solenoid. The portion of the solenoid is a circular coil. That circular coil thickness is x. Then this is called, what is the radius? R is the radius. Right? R is the radius. Right? This is called R is the radius. Now, this circular coil is making an angle. This circular coil is making an angle vertical. This is called, what to say, phi. This is called, what to say, phi. Now, here, from that one, right, this is called, what to say, circular coil. Right? A portion of the solenoid behaves as a circular coil of thickness dx. Right? Here, for current carrying circular coil, B is equals to mu naught I n r square into 2 into r square plus x square all to the power of 3 by 2. What is n? Right? Total number of turns. Here, how many number of turns in this circular coil? Already we know that. Number of turns per unit length is equals to n. For 1 meter thickness, n. For 2 meter thickness, 2n. For 3 meters thickness, 3n. For dx thickness, the number of turns are represented by n into dx. Here where, right? Total number of turns